Chuck Schumer essentially just said what Major Garrett told me earlier when we were talking about this in the wake of their meeting with President Trump in the Oval Office. So let's go back to Major, who's standing by at the White House lawn. So Major, yeah, basically.
Let me just say this. Led. I got to say this, okay, because I've done this for a lot of years, all right? Usually what happens is the two negotiators, in this case Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer, come into the Oval Office. The president, whomever it is, sits there. There are some opening comments, very polite, very bipartisan, and then we're ushered out. Then they have this conversation, then they come to the microphones and tell us what happened. Not today. What we saw was the whole conversation, and what Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer just came out didn't add one iota to what we watched in the actual Oval Office. They didn't enlarge the conversation at all. Nancy Pelosi said, well, we didn't want to say the president was unfactual. She said that to his face while we were all watching in the Oval Office. So what I'm only trying to convey to the audience is usually there's some gap in time and some mystery. Oh, what really went on in the room? Now we know exactly what went on in the room. They showed it all. Every card was laid on the table. And the meeting that happened in private, I think, lasted less time than the one we actually saw play out in public. So one had to exactly mirror the other, because what Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer just said afterwards is what they said while it was going on. So what the country learned is what happened in the Oval Office. The president called it transparency. Nancy Pelosi suggested it was devolving, getting out of control. Either way, both sides represented themselves forcefully, directly, and we all got to watch it. So I'm all in favor of that.
Yeah, no, transparency is key. The president even pointing that out. I do think, though, Major, one of the reasons I wanted to get you back to talk to you about this before we wrap this up is at one point Nancy Pelosi saying, well, this is spiraling, and I'm paraphrasing what she said here. She said this is spiraling out of control. But this, as you pointed out, it was so different than what we've seen in the past, where the president of the United States sits with leaders of both parties. They make some small talk for the cameras. They say that they're going to work things out behind closed doors, and then the press is shooed away for the business
right.
of the people.
Then they go out at hammer and tong, and now we got to see the hammer and tong part.
Yeah,
which that's exactly what happens.
That was
what's the takeaway? Someone's watching and say, well, so what? We got to watch it. Well, first of all, it's great. It's interesting. It's hardly ever been seen before. I've certainly never witnessed it. All right, so it's unique. Is there anything other than its uniqueness that makes it memorable? Yes. Because what you saw was legislative fencing, if I can use that pun, and a sense of letting people who have large constituencies, the President of the United States, the Senate Democratic leader, the House Democratic leader, make their political statements face to face, forcefully, exchange differences of opinion, and do that for all the public to see. There is benefit derived for all parties in that. And guess what? The country will digest that, and the sum total of a political reaction will begin to be signaled back to this White House, Nancy Pelosi, and Chuck Schumer. I guarantee you, every current Democrat in the Congress is watching this. Every incoming Democrat is watching this. All the Republicans are watching it and gaining all the signals from what's going to happen in the next week or so based on what everyone was able to watch, not just the insiders, not just someone who was in the room who gives some sort of varied or partial version of what happened. We all saw what happened. And the political ramifications will echo from that because everyone got a chance to see exactly the same thing.
And Major, finally, I guess this just brings, what you just said brings an interesting question to my mind. Given the fact that we talked about how experienced Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer are on the Hill, a part of me wonders if there wasn't a little bit of grandstanding here from the Democrats, because we never saw this, as you pointed out, we've never seen this, but even when Republicans were completely against President Obama's agenda, whether it was related to health care or immigration, and they would sit in that Oval Office and you could see those tight smiles on their faces. They never contradicted him in public like that before the cameras.
Right.
And I just think, I wonder to myself, given what they know about how things work in Washington, D.C., was this some sort of a signal to their supporters, to the numerous Democrats who've been elected to Congress in this, what some are calling this blue wave? What's your take on that?
Sure, and one thing that's important to understand about politics, particularly at the higher levels, is grandstanding can be a tactic. Grandstanding is not always, or even more often than not, an empty gesture. Sometimes grandstanding, meaning you're making a political point and you're sort of doing it in a slightly over-the-top way to make sure that point gets across. You're sort of larger than life, larger than you need to be in that moment to make an impression. To make an impression on the person you're talking to, make an impression on those who are watching, make an impression on those who you represent. And what Democrats have learned from this president is, A, he's okay with this kind of confrontation. He likes it. He has an appetite for it. And if you're going to challenge him, and if you're going to take up your legislative agenda aggressively, you have to meet his aggression face to face and equally. Be respectful of the office, be respectful of the president, but take your agenda aggressively to him face to face, even if you'd rather not. And clearly, Nancy Pelosi said a couple of times, I'd rather not be doing this. But guess what? The cameras are there. If you shrink away, it appears that you're either, if not abandoning your agenda, giving it less credence than the president is giving his. And Democrats have learned, you've got to meet him measure for measure, verb for verb, adjective for adjective, directness with directness. Because if you don't, your supporters will perceive some measure of weakness. And if Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer want to convey anything to this president or this White House at this particular stage of this transition from one Congress going out to a new one led by a House Democratic majority coming in, Democrats want to be aggressive, want to represent their agenda, and don't mind doing so in public.
Major Garrett for us at the White House. Major, I'm just very happy that I got to witness the inner workings of our government live on the air. And I had you as a journalist, as a teacher, as somebody who could sort of break it down for it and school us all on what we were actually witnessing. Thank you, sir, so much. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Vlad.